Good morning students, welcome back to the English Channel Prime for grade 7. Students, today we are going to learn about the most adored, the revolutionary freedom fighter, the fierce patriot, the leader with indomitable courage and vigor. Yes students, the most prominent real hero of our nation, the one and only person who has raised a complete army, that is Indian National Army or NAS, Azad Hind Fauj. Yes students, we all know about him. He is our favorite, most favorite. So we are going to learn Unit 7, that is a tribute to Netaji, that is Subhas Chandra Bose. This is our last chapter in this syllabus. So students, paragraph wise, I'll give the gist or explanation of this chapter on Subhas Bose's life, about his childhood. We'll learn about his education, his qualities, his contributions and his entire life history. So let's start students. Students, Subhas Chandra Bose was the only leader who raised a modern army of about 75,000 men and women and moved ahead with his meticulous plans to wage a war against the British. He asked Indians to give him their blood and he would give them freedom. His famous slogans are Jai Hind and Dilli Chalo. So children, we are going to learn about him. Subhas Bose was born at Cuttack, Odisha on January 23, 1897. His father Janakinath Bose was a famous lawyer and mother was Prabhavati Devi. He was the ninth in the family of 14 children. Students, Subhas Chandra Bose passed his BA in philosophy from the Presidency College of Calcutta. In 1916, he organized a student strike to demonstrate against an English professor who had insulted pushing away an Indian student. So it showed his rebellious nature. Students, he belonged to an educated and prosperous family. So during his childhood, he was brought into touch with English people, English education and English culture. But as he grew, he became inclined towards our culture, both classical and modern. Also, he used to follow the teachings of Swami Vivekananda and Aurobindo Ghosh in the spiritual sphere and Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das in politics. As you know children, both the Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs all adored him as Netaji. He was equally respected by all the people over India. On September 15, 1919, in order to study and appear at the ICS, Indian Civil Services exam. After a year, he came out successfully by standing fourth in the order of merit, securing highest marks in English. But his concern did not allow him to serve the alien rulers even as a high executive. So he resigned from the ICS and returned to India to become an active member of the India's independence movement. Students, now Bose came back to Calcutta and joined as a principal of National College at Calcutta with the mentorship of Chittaranjan Das. But during non-cooperation movement, he again left that job and participated in that movement. Then again he was arrested by the British for joining this movement. After release, he formed the Swaraj Party and was appointed as the editor of the party's journal, that is Forward. Bose became the executive officer of the Calcutta Corporation in 1924. During that time, the Britishers put him into jail in and out repeatedly most of the times. Bose was a great thinker, a visionary, and he used to do through action. So he made such an impact on the Congress that he was elected twice as the president of the Indian National Congress in 1938 and 39 for the two sessions. He used to tell about complete Swaraj. War was broke out in September 1939. Subhas was against rendering any kind of help to the Britishers. Britain was engaged in the World War And so, Gandhiji and Nehru were of the opinion that the Congress should not take advantage of Britain's difficulties. But Subhash Chandra Bose had strong views. He started a mass movement against the utilizing the Indian resources and men for the World War II. To him, it made no sense to further bleed the poor Indians for the sake of the colonial and imperial nations. So he travelled throughout the country to organize public opinion against the war effort. So he was arrested on July 2, 1940 at Madras. On November 26, 1940, he went on hunger strike to protest against the ill treatment of the prisoners. As his condition suddenly worsened, he was released but was kept under the police surveillance. Bose escaped from the British and reached Kabul, and from there he went to Berlin via Moscow. The whole country was thrilled when his voice was heard over the Berlin radio. Broadcast from German radio sent shockwaves among all the Britishers, and that electrified the Indian masses, who realized that their leader was working on a master plan to free their motherland. He gave fresh confidence to the revolutionaries who were challenging the Britishers in many ways. So, when the Japan entered the World War, Subhash left for Japan. He went to Singapore and took over the leadership of the Indian independence movement. Subhash went to Southeast Asia and organized the Indian National Army to fight against the British. The Indian soldiers and civilians at once declared their Netaji or allegiance to him. He accepted them as the Netaji. Both all the Muslims, Sikhs, men, women, all of them accepted him as Netaji and gave the inspiring call of Jai Hind and Dilli Chalo. While launching the war, Netaji went on air again on July 6, 1944 and sought Gandhiji's blessings in the following words. He said, "Father of our nation, in this holy war of India's liberation, we ask for your blessings and good wishes." Students, as you know, the Indian National Army fought so well that it soon liberated about 3,200 square kilometers of Indian territory from the well-entrenched British Army. But soon it was beset by various difficulties such as lack of communication, food, rigors of the monsoon, the changing monsoon, and the breakdown of the supplies. On the other hand, the Japanese forces were also withdrawn because of the atom bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, as the war went badly for them. But the Indian National Army refused to retreat, with the result that thousands of soldiers were captured by the British forces. Now, most of the armies were captured, disarmed and court-martialed. Jawaharlal Nehru, he organized and conducted their defense. Ultimately, the government released them. Then, Netaji boarded a Japanese aircraft for Tokyo on August 18, 1945. The plane landed in Formosa at noon, and according to the Japanese sources, it caught fire while taking off. Netaji was badly burned but managed to come out of the plane. He came out of the plane, he was rushed to a hospital, where he was declared as died the same night. Refused to believe that Netaji is dead. Students, it is amazing how much Subhash Chandra Bose was able to achieve, accomplish in his very short life of 48 years. He was a brilliant student and he could have easily let or attained a high position of power as an Indian civil service officer. He could lead an aristocratic life, but he preferred a life of trials and tribulations. As a fighter for his country's freedom, he sacrificed his youth. His proud and independent spirit mocked at the ill health and ill fortune. He was a doer as well as a thinker, a visionary, a fighter who never submitted to defeat. In life, he was a natural leader of men who inspired immense devotion and loyalty. Students, in death also he became a legend. People till now refuse to believe that Netaji is dead. Perhaps they are right, for martyrs never die. Students, I am going to give you the real speech. Students, Subhash Chandra had a special regard for his Muslim countrymen. Some of his ancestors, forefathers like Mahipati Bose and Gopinath Bose had held the offices of the minister and naval commanders under the Muslim rulers of Bengal. So, his Indian National Army brought us sacrifices and unity irrespective of class and community and discipline. So students, now I hope you understand this lesson. Let's do the hard words and meanings, that is the glossary words. First word, unique, meaning being the only one of its type or unusual. Brute, meaning cruel or strong. Forward, meaning spirit. Prosperous, meaning successful and rich. Prospective, meaning a view. Quest, meaning an attempt to find something or a lone search. Sphere, meaning an area of interest. Look upon, meaning consider. Renounce, meaning give up. Rebellious, meaning disobedient. Apparent, meaning seen or understood. Consignee, meaning moral sense. Alien, meaning a foreigner. Mentor, meaning trusted advisor. Impact, meaning profound effect. Urge, meaning advice or advocate. Ultimatum, meaning final warning. Surveillance, meaning a close watch kept on someone. Allegiance, meaning loyalty or faith. Retreat, meaning move back. Tribulation, meaning misery or trouble. Immense, meaning great. Legend, meaning an old story about great events and people. Martyr, meaning someone who dies for a cause, for the nation. So hope all of you understood this. If any doubt, ask in the comment box.